right. One chance of proving to the world that he was right. I'm too hungry not to get that win, but I just gotta remember one thing. Gotta keep my head up, never get that low, cause I'm living this life, now it's all I know. Like, oh, it's the life I chose.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to NSW Smackdown Live on Nonstop Sport. My name is, of course, Dave Easton, alongside Marky Marks and Tim Price. Marky, good evening.
Good evening, Dave.
And Tim Price from looking for Tim Rage. Good evening.
Good evening, Dave. I'm still a bit shaken.
Guys, we've got big news. Paul Heyman has said tonight Umuggle will defend the European title, and he's going to tell us in just a few short minutes.
Yeah, I can't wait to see who Umuggle's going to defend that championship against.
Well, we're going to find out. And oh, here they come. Look at the gold, Marky.
Yeah, so much gold on them. Paul Heyman must be impressed.
Yeah. We've got the NSW champion Brock Lesnar, the tag team champions in Mundo and AJ Styles, and Seth, I sold out Rollins.
Mean Seth, I bought in Rollins?
Well,
sold out.
Let's see what happens here. Well, you can't argue he has got the people with the gold, Tim.
Yeah, can you imagine? Well, if he then got the European Championship as well?
Well, let's find out, of course. Who he has promised us who he's going to take on. I'm just stunned. Look at the gold in there, though.
Yeah, that's why we've gone to Fort Knox.
He's saying that they don't have the European title, so tonight. What?
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 Oh
my goodness.
Oh my god. Omegle Mundo late on tonight.
Oh, no.
This could be, well, Heyman laying all his cards on the line here.
Yeah, but, well, I'm wondering, Hunter's a Heyman guy. Why can't he go for the European Championship? Or is he just security now?
He's head of security.
Yeah.
Wow. And, of course, the main event tonight, Brock Lesnar, Seth Rollins taking on the team of CM Barnett and Adrian Kincade. And we know what them two did to Brock Lesnar at the end of Night of Champions. Do you know he wants revenge here tonight?
Sharon, one thing you don't want to do is make Brock Lesnar angry.
Well, we're going to find out. Coming up first, we're going to start with some tag team action as the Real Americans take on the Ascension.
There is seeing the Real Americans ready to take on the Ascension. Big tag team action. There was two people I bumped into on my way to find Tim Rage.
Who, the Ascension?
Yeah.
Well,
that wasn't too bad.
Coming to the ring first, they're being led by Zeb Coulter, the team of Connor Rhodes, Bo Dallas, the Real Americans.
Yeah, there we see. Well, Connor Rhodes, the newest member of the Real Americans. Some people shocked with that. But hey, I think it could be a great career move for him.
Marky, what do you make of these two?
They've been electrifying the whole entire tag team universe so far. I mean, Connor Rhodes, he was having great success in the singles and then went over to a tag again.
Yeah. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, we do have to advise you, tonight is the last night for the points before they all get reset. We will announce a winner after the show. If you want to win the prize, you've got to be the top dog. So get your votes in here tonight. And well, ladies and gentlemen, making their way to the ring, the team of Connor and Victor, the Ascension.
Eppen. The Ascension skiff of an eerie presence, you could say, when they make their way to the ring.
And of course, former tag team champions.
Yep, so you know, the Ascension, they definitely know how to get it done in that ring. They've well been impressive, and you could see them do that again one day.
Well, all I can say, remember guys, this is the last night. If you're in the NSW, I'll remind you through the night. If you want to be a part, if you want to win it, you've got to put your points on. This is your last chance before the points go back to zero for NXT on Saturday night. Marky, your opinions on the Ascension?
A very weird tag team here. I mean, definitely a very intimidating force to be messing with.
Well, let's find out who's going to pick up the win in our first match tonight. It is the Ascension versus the Real Americans. It's coming up here on SmackDown. And we are off and underway. Let's start with the guys here. Let's see what Marky has to say.
I'm going to go for the Real Americans.
Okay, Tim?
Yeah, I'm also going to go with the Real Americans. You know, they've got Zeb Coller out there, and Conor Rhodes is now joining the Real Americans, and we know what he can do in the tag division.
Yeah, of course, Conor Rhodes and Bo Dallas will be looking very much at the tag team champions of Mundo and AJ Styles. Mundo tonight can win the European title. Double champion here in NSW. Could be, the Heyman guy's being very impressive as already. Oh, 2.5.
My God.
I thought that was it already.
So did I. That was so close. And, oh, here comes a double team move. The ref. Let's get Conor Rhodes out of there, though. No, could end disqualification.
Already the Real Americans being on top here. And Marky, you've got to think the Real Americans looking very impressive here early on in this contest. Just as I say that, here comes Victor.
Yeah, looking very impressive so far, and so far being a dominant.
Oh my goodness.
Gosh.
Lovely double team.
Yeah, the spear and clothesline combination.
And of course, so much more to come tonight. Of course, we've got Bray Wyatt in action against Darren Young. That's coming up. We've also got a big fatal four-way for the European number one contender. As a two count there by Bo Dallas. Oh, the spear!
My goodness.
Oh, he hits it, and I think Connor might be busted. Yeah, he's busted open from that.
That could be it. Victor's been thrown back inside the ring, and Bo Dallas has the leg hooked, and that is three. And the Real Americans with a big win tonight.
Yeah, the Real Americans, well, showing what they can do, and Connor Rhodes back in the tag division now, and, well, picking where he could say he left off.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this contest, the team of Conor Rhodes and Bo Dallas, the Real Americans.
And oh, just look at the blood on Conor's head.
What a start, though, for the Real Americans here tonight. They pick up a big win in their continuing quest. I'm sure they're going to be tag team number one contenders very soon. Whoa!
Whoa, what's going on here?
Titus O'Neil? Oh no, please tell me Darren Young doesn't have to face Bray Wyatt by himself later on.
Oh no.
Oh, that could be...
That could be bad.
Yeah, very bad.
Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, a singles match from our women. It's Caitlin versus Jillian. At least that's the one
way. Yep, well, this, you know, I'd say two of the most skilled women in SW taking on each other.
And what about this coming out of the women's division on Monday night, guys? The Divas title. Well, unofficial, let's just say.
It's not
this.
A real championship. Desi Diamond, it's just the fact she lost.
That is, Marky, what do you think of that?
I think that's just pathetic, having to make your own championship make yourself feel better.
And we'll have to see what comes of that, of course. Our champion Layla, of course, first title reign, has said that she will give a rematch to this Destiny Diamond. We'll have to wait to find out how it goes down there in the next few weeks.
Yeah, you've got to wonder what Kaylee and AJ are thinking about this whole Divas title situation. Well, will it become legit or...
Who knows, but of course AJ Lee, of course, has called all the women Divas at the beginning of the season, remember that?
Yeah, I don't think she's going to want to hold that championship if it becomes real.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, making her way to the ring, she is AJ Lee.
And AJ Lee, well, a former NSW Women's Champion.
Well, very decorated Women's Champion as well.
Yeah.
Just, you have to give AJ a lot of credit for the work she's put in the Women's Division. Of course, not really had the best of views at time at the rest of the women. Tim, but you've got to say, when it comes to getting the job done, AJ three times wins champion.
And you know, I've agreed with her views about the whole Divas thing, and well, this whole new Desi Dunn bringing in a Divas championship only kind of, well, makes what AJ said a little bit more true.
It's true. What about you, Marky? What do you make of all of this?
It's definitely a very interesting thing. I mean, proving AJ Wright with that Divas Championship.
Well, we're off and underway for the next match. Guys, let's see who you guys have gone for. Let's start with Tim.
No, I've gone with AJ Lee. You know, she's one of the most, if not the most, decorated women's champions we've had. I think she, you know, wants to get back in to get another shot at that championship.
What about you, Marky?
I'm also going to go for AJ Lee. I believe that she has always been a great contender. I mean, it was multiple championships have done her well.
Well, NSW up 64.8 going for Caitlin, 35.2 going for AJ Lee. Of course, Caitlin had this sort of turn really into a bit of a heel turn recently. And many people are saying that her changes of ways have really helped her get up. Of course, she had a title shot a few weeks ago, and really back at the pay-per-view, which of course wasn't one, she did was unsuccessful. But you have to say, Tim, her new attitude this season merely has got her up in the top of the ranks here.
Yep, showing off, you know, a more aggressive side. Now showed that she can get it done in a ring, and well, not trying to be friends with anyone anymore.
Yeah, maybe the softer side of her has gone, and maybe this is what she needs to get to the top and stay at the top.
I'd have to agree with that.
Marky, what do you think about this new whole attitude from Caitlin?
I think it's definitely going to help her. I mean, having more aggression in the rings is going to help Caitlin here, as she's never held gold yet.
Yeah, look at that nice spinning heel kick. Big victory over here over AJ Lee, and yeah, you could think that maybe she might be getting another contender shot here. But AJ, look at that! Oh, nice! Hurricane Rana. And then the aggressiveness, nice kick to the back.
Now, so I think whoever wins this match could definitely be in the next one to challenge for the Women's Championship.
We'll find out, of course, what is going to go down with the women, of course. Hopefully we'll find something out on Raw this coming Monday night. Of course, the women can appear on both shows in NSW.
Yeah, I mean, could we... Oh, there's a pinfall here.
No, just a one. You were saying?
Let's say, if this Divas Championship was made, you know, legit and everything, would that mean a Divas roster split, maybe?
I don't know. We'd have to see what the GMs think. But now, look at this. AJ putting Caitlin on top. Shot to the
what's
back.
What's she going for here?
Back suplex center of the ring. And Caitlin could like be out here.
Yeah, it looked like she landed badly on that.
And then two elbows to follow it up. AJ completely in command here.
Yeah, I mean, we said about Caitlin, you know, having an aggressive side, but don't count out AJ for not having an aggressive side, but...
Look at this. What the world is this?
What in the... It's like an armbar submission. I don't know how to describe it. It's like some kind of armbar submission.
Yeah, double armbar. She's like pushing back on the neck, like, and then with the arms. And
how
AJ,
would you tap out?
I think verbally, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I think you'd have to start nodding your head or something.
Definitely having to do something here as AJ. Now look at this, AJ into the abdominal stretch.
Yeah, into a submission of her own. And Caitlin could be in serious trouble.
Yeah, and all of a sudden after Caitlin thought she might have won this one, AJ, look at this, wrenching back.
Abdominal stretch.
I think she's fading, guys. She looks like she is fading badly.
Yeah, Caitlin looks like she's in a lot of trouble. AJ could have this match won with the abdominal stretch.
Look at this here. She has been in that move for now. Just coming up. And there it is!
Oh, there's the tap. And
she had no option, ladies and gentlemen. AJ Lee wins by submission.
And, well, what an impressive win for AJ Lee here tonight. Well, we could be looking at the next contender for the Women's Championship.
Yeah, the winner of this match, ladies and gentlemen, AJ Lee.
Epic. Well, now skipping around. Celebrating her big victory. Now, I'd look forward to seeing AJ Lee take a well. At the moment, Layla. They could all change.
That is could happen, Layla. The women's champion will be looking on. Big win for AJ Lee. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, NSW comes your way four times a week. Raw on a Monday, main event on a Wednesday. Us three on SmackDown on a Thursday. Me and Tim will be back on Saturday night with NXT. Nonstop Wrestling UK is the YouTube. Over 500 subscribers now. Thank you. Thank you so much for everyone who took the time to do that. NSW_360 if you're on Twitter, and it's NSW365 if you're on Facebook. Show start 11 o'clock in the UK, 6 in the East, 3 in the West. If you are watching us on the network, hit the subscribe button. Doesn't cost you anything. Coming up next, what about this, guys? Bray Wyatt is going to take on Darren Young and no Titus O'Neil.
Yeah, Darren Young looks like he's in a lot of trouble now, taking on Bray Wyatt. Whoa, Luke Harper's out there for Bray Wyatt.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring first, he is Darren Young.
Yeah, but well, here we see Darren Young, a former NSW Tag Team Champion, but, well, coming out here in a lot of trouble now, have to take on Bray Wyatt with no Titus O'Neil out there for him.
Give him a lot of credit, though.
Because, yeah, he's not backing down.
Yeah, he's coming out. He's coming out for a fight here.
So you got to give it to him, having the courage to come out here. And, you know, not back down one bit.
Well, Darren Young ready for action here tonight. And his opponent being led to the ring by Luke Harper. He is Bray Wyatt.
And here we see Bray Wyatt, and just gives you the creeps a little bit, along with Luke Harper. I mean, he's just a very out there individual, and this opposition with Sting now seems to have just gone.
Well,
he's done with Sting, isn't he?
And he said he moved on.
Yeah, he's what his goal here is, to just take out the SmackDown roster. That is the thing. He has said he's going to take the SmackDown roster out one by one until he gets the NSW title.
Well, that's exactly, you know, the way Bray Wyatt's got to be. To be the top dog here in NSW. And, well, as scary it is to think about, he's going about it in the right way.
Ladies and gentlemen, remember, as always, you have only got, what, 5 more matches left now to get your votes in to win the points. It is coming up. Wyatt versus Darren Young. Okay, guys, let's start with Marky this time.
I'm going to go for Bray Wyatt.
Okay, Tim?
I also have to go with Bray Wyatt. You know, Darren Young does not have Titus O'Neil out there for him. And, well, Luke Harper's out there for Bray Wyatt.
And also, Darren Young has not been in singles competition for a very long time here in NSW. Bray Wyatt is on a bit of a roll. 92.2% of the NSW have gone for Bray Wyatt. 7.8% going for Darren Young.
Wow.
I would. You know what it is? What would this do, Tim? Let's talk about this. If Darren Young wins this match, right? Say he pulls a victory off you. What does that do for his career? Yes?
Yeah, you're exactly right. I mean, Darren Young, if he gets a win, he's beaten a former NSW champion, a former world heavyweight champion.
Yeah.
That would be a huge win for his career.
And you have to think, that is going to propel him up on the rankings. And maybe Paul Heyman might be looking, saying, okay, we've got to give this guy a shot.
But then, how is Titus O'Neil going to think about that, if that was to happen?
And who took out Titus O'Neil? I've probably got a suspicion who it could be.
Is he standing just outside the ring?
Yeah, surprisingly, yeah.
Or it could have been Eric Rowan.
Yeah,
he's not here.
Marky, are you got any ideas who it could have been?
I think it could definitely could have been Eric. I mean, where is he?
That is true. Eric Rowan not at ringside. Of course, you're only limited to have one manager. Can you call? Well, I wouldn't want to argue with Bray Wyatt, but I'm saying, could Luke Harper be classed as a manager?
I don't know. I think he's just scary guy looking out for Bray Wyatt. And scary girl that should
look at this.
Well, maybe, yeah, he's got the submission, and then Luke Harper's there to stop it. And
Darren
actually,
Young.
I'm not going to make a comment about Luke Harper. It could do damage to my health.
Darren Young, though, look at this. If Darren Young could get Bray Wyatt to tap out here in the center of the ring, Marky, what would that? As I say, Darren Young would definitely be in a chance, maybe for a European title shot.
Yeah, it would definitely have to be looked into the singles career. I mean, again, Titus O'Neil might not be happy about that, but Darren Young could be looked at.
Yeah, but look at that—a big splash down by Bray Wyatt. Now just taking Darren Young from the away from the ropes into the cover. Hook of the leg. Is that enough? No, Young's still got a lot left in him. He's only got a one count there.
Yeah, it's going to take more than that to take a guy like Taron Young down. I mean, he is tough. He has got tenacity about him.
Yeah, look at this now. Just driving the shoulders into the midsection. And look, and now aggressiveness coming out here.
Yeah, Taron Young's showing what he can do, and the fact he's not going to back down from a guy like Bray Wyatt, even if Tyson was taken out earlier.
And look at this now. Just throwing Bray Wyatt over the top. Should really take more advantage here. Nice big shot. Now what's he going to do?
Uh-oh, this looks bad.
Look out! Dropping him down on the side of the ring. Taron Young in control here. And look at this. The knee drop.
Yeah, he hits that gut buster. The outside of
the ring.
Yeah, he has to get him back. Yeah, Marky, you're completely right. He does need to get him inside the ring. Bray Wyatt, though, getting some help off Luke Harper. And, well, Bray Wyatt's probably not thought that this was going to be an easy match, and Taron Young has completely proven us wrong.
Yeah, I think Bray Wyatt thought Taron Young was going to be easy pickings in this match, and Taron Young's proven him completely wrong.
Now look at this, just dropping the elbow right down across the back. What a takedown. And, well, this could be the beginning of the end. Oh, big high cross body into the cover. Is that enough to take away Taron Young? No! King out of 2.9.
Oh, and he's continuing to fight on.
Mr. Abigail!
Now I think he's done.
And just like that, Bray Wyatt into the cover. Hook of the leg. There's the three. And Bray Wyatt picks up the win.
Yep. Taron Young. Oh, sorry. You carry on, Marky.
Taron Young, he did have an impressive performance out there, but just couldn't pick up the win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match, Bray Wyatt.
Yep, and saying it was too much for Taron Young, impressive, but there's your winner. Well, let's say when the cameraman, there we go, there's your winner, Bray Wyatt. I wouldn't want to get in his way, let's put it that way.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Bray Wyatt. And I think we're going to hear from him. Yep. Can we have our lights back, please?
Please,
I can't see. Wish we have our
monitors here.
Well, yeah. I can't even see out of mine.
At least we can hear them.
Which is always a good thing.
Yeah, they're right in front of us.
And seeing Bray Wyatt saying here that he's not going to stop at anyone until he gets the NSW title, and Harper and Rowan are looking at the tag titles. Oh my goodness. Is the Wyatt family trying to get back into power? It looks definitely that way.
Dude, can you imagine if Harper and Rowan held the tag team titles?
Could happen.
If it's possible.
Oh my goodness. Bray Wyatt and Luke Harper, you do not want to mess with the Wyatt family. Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, the European Championship is on the line as Umuggle defends against the Heyman Lackey in the Mundo.
Yep, here we see Umuggle defend his European title against the Heyman guy at the Mundo.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring first, being accompanied by Oliver Bisping. He is your reigning, defending European champion, Umuggle.
Yep, Umuggle will make his way to ring one of the most dominant European champions, well, if not the most dominant European champion we've seen, of that championship.
What a chance here for the Mundo to become the new European title. The whole two titles here on SmackDown. You've got to think this is so unfair. I'm not a big fan of the Bisping boys, but Tim, come on. Heyman just wants everything.
And what's wrong with that, you know? Heyman wants power, and he's the general manager.
Yeah, but to just put Umuggle into a match here.
I think Heyman needs another meeting.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring, being accompanied by one half of the tag team champions, AJ Styles. He is the It Factor of NSW, the Mundo.
And Marky, that meeting was held with Paul Heyman and obviously Vince McMahon, Vince McMundo, saw that Paul Heyman's done a stellar job here on SmackDown as general manager and said, you keep your job.
Yeah, but if he continues this, I think there's going to be another meeting.
I don't think so. I think that initial meeting was just to tell Paul Heyman how great he was doing.
Well, Mundo has the chance here. Let's get things going. European title is on the line. Here tonight.
And, well, here we see these two. Ready and set.
Okay, Marky, let's see who you think's going to win this one.
It's got to be a Muggle. Great European champion right there.
Wow, look at the strength of Mundo.
My God.
Wow.
Goodness.
Tim, who you think's going to win this one?
You know, I'm going to go with the Mundo. You know, he's a Paul Heyman guy. He's got AJ Styles on there. I think this could be the Muggle's downfall here tonight.
Well, let's find out. Of course, what's Bisping going to think if he loses this? And he has no titles in his camp, and Heyman's got all of them.
Yeah, Bisping is not going to be in the happiest of moods. And he's going to look, well, to go against Paul Heyman. That may not be the best career move.
Mundo working over here. Oh, my goodness, kicking in the midsection. And then a kick to the head. And Magal's showing aggressive. And what? AJ Styles distracting the referee, if you notice there, guys. Don't know if that's going to help Mundo at all here.
And another kick to the head from Umuggle.
Mundo and AJ Styles, of course, retained the tag team titles this past week against Bisping Boys Morgan Wolf and Dom. And you have to say, this is sort of turned into sort of a Heyman versus Bisping feud.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you can see it, but as I said, you know, at the end, it could be Heyman who really walks out with the victory.
Yeah. Look out.
Oh, God. Just sitting on the chest.
But you say that, but also it could be Bisping that walks out with all championships if Heyman gets desperate.
That is true. Look at... Oh. End of the submission.
Oh.
The Boston Crab.
Yeah, we thought he was going to go for the swing, but no, he's got the Boston Crab locked in, and the man looks like he's in a lock. He could tap out.
He could, if he could get him to tap out here. Oh, he gets to the ropes.
Yeah, just about. That was...
Oh, what a belly to belly.
Muggle is just dominating in this matchup.
And AJ's up. And maybe that's the thing that's kept Mundo in this, because Mundo could have been out.
Yeah, I think that was a three count. Oh, my goodness.
Another kick to the head. Muggle's just scary when he's in this ring. He's like a man possessed when it comes to the European Championship.
Look at the strength of Mundo, though. Don't count Mundo out here.
It was all strength there.
Oh, and this has got... Can't quite get the full grip on the Fujiwara armbar.
Yeah, now look at this. Now the armbar into the headlock. Mundo not backing down here. Sending Umuggle in, but not taking advantage. Looking very slowly. I think it's maybe the match taking the effect here on Mundo, Marky. You've got to think Mundo has really got to stay on Umuggle if he's going to win this.
Yeah, you got to. He's used to tag him. Wait.
Well, he's just kicking Umuggle down.
Something's distracting Mundo up on the ramp. I can't see anyone.
Yeah, who's there?
What is Mundo doing? Was something distracting Mundo?
Oh, come on. Mundo was unfairly distracted.
Oh, good night. That is it.
It's got to be it.
That's
gotta be one,
it,
two,
but
three
this is a complete travesty of justice.
Edge is up. Edge has blocked him. This match will continue on.
Thank you, AJ, for stopping the travesty from happening.
And again, Edge is up. I'm being told that Kincade was standing at the top of the ramp, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, kidding.
I couldn't see who it was. I can only apologise. My monitor's
playing
up here.
I think Mundo's going to tap here. I think he's going
to
tap.
Oh, he has!
Oh!
And Michael wins!
The Mundo got completely screwed by Kincade. And there's your winner, Umuggle, but this is a travesty of justice if I've ever seen one.
Adrian Kincade has done it again! And he has thwarted Heyman in getting the title. Umuggle continues his reign as European champion.
Who's going to take that off him? If Mundo couldn't do it, who will?
And Mando could have done if it wasn't for Kincade.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match, still European champion, Umuggle.
No, Margo, I think you got lucky here tonight if it wasn't for Kincade.
Well, we are backstage now with Daniel Cage. Of course, Daniel Cage is going to be part of the Fatal 4-Way to determine the number one contender next for Umuggle. It will be DM West, Ryback, Daniel Cage and Morgan Wolf. That who has got a chance to win it a little bit later on. Three matches still to go, ladies and gentlemen, tonight. The points are still on the board. You can still have a chance to win it. It is so tight if you look in the chat. And Daniel Cage saying that he has a chance at the European title tonight. He says it is time for the Cage to take his chance. Again, Tim, another guy who recently... This could be a big chance for Daniel Cage here tonight to get a shot at a Umuggle.
Yep, this is a big shot for Daniel Cage, but... Well, he could be, you know, he could be the one to beat Umuggle for that European Championship.
Well, you're seeing here tonight, when he gets his hand raised, Bisping better watch out, because he's going to smack the taste right out of his mouth.
Ooh.
Wow.
Be careful what you say, Daniel Cage.
Yeah, you really... Daniel Cage ready for action here tonight. Thanks very much, Renee Young. Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, by orders of Paul Heyman, Daniel Bryan and Danny Six are going to team up against Sami Zayn and Adrian Neville. The winner of this match gets a tag team title shot next week.
Wow.
Well, this should be a great matchup between four, you know, you say, fast-paced high flyers.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring first, he's from Aberdeen, Washington. He is Daniel Bryan.
Here comes Daniel Bryan. Well, you can... Yeah, I think they've been probably named the Yes Movement.
I'm sorry, I'm getting word. All right, okay. I'm sorry, this wasn't made by Paul Heyman. This was made by Mr. McMundo.
Oh,
who says, man, we need number one contenders for next week's show. Wow.
Interesting.
I don't know why, again, he's getting involved. I thought Heyman was back in charge.
Not for it. Maybe that's what the conference is about, saying Vince is going to step in for some matches.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, his tag team partner from Bolton, England, he is Danny Six.
Yep, and well, it looks like Danny Six has found a great tag team partner in Daniel Bryan. Well, you can say they're both two big fan favourites.
Yeah, they are. I can't say anything more than that.
They're two big fan favourites and now found, well, themselves as a tag team.
Are they really a tag team?
Well, they've been...
He helped him out on Sunday night. I wouldn't call it a tag team.
Well, they've teamed up before, though.
Okay, then. Fair enough.
You can say the same about Neville and Zayn, that they've teamed up before, but not that much.
Well, Danny Six, the crowd going wild for Danny Six. They are ready to see this tag team contest. Look at Danny playing in the crowd. The crowd love him, ladies and gentlemen. They are ready to see him in action with Daniel Bryan the other night.
Yep, just where's that playing to a crowd.
And their opponents coming to the ring first from Canada. He is Sami Zayn.
Yep, there we see, well, Sami Zayn, and well, he'll be teaming up with Neville, who we see. I think it's another two people we've seen tag occasionally, but he's saying they're not a fully fledged tag team. But well, that could all change tonight.
Two big cruiserweights here as a tag team. I've got to think that Neville and Sami Zayn, if they put their mind to it, could be very good for this tag team division.
Yeah, definitely could be. I think both of these teams, you know, could be very good for the tag team division.
Well, we are ready to go for this one. We're just waiting for one more person, and it's this guy from Newcastle upon Tyne. He is the man that gravity forgot, Neville.
after well, when you say about the whole cruiserweight division, and well, a great guy to team up with Sami Zayn, it is Neville. Now they're two, you know, great high flyers that love to defy the odds of gravity.
What do you make of Neville?
He's a great high flyer. I mean, he's definitely one of the best here in NSW, and he's a great addition to a SmackDown to have.
Well, Neville, Sami Zayn versus Danny Six and Daniel Bryan. It's coming up next on SmackDown.
Yep, both teams, well, they look very ready for this matchup. We'll see who'll become number one contenders.
Well, we're off and underway. Guys, let's start with Marky. Who are you going for in this one?
I'm going for Danny Six and Daniel Bryan.
Okay, what about you, Tim?
No, I'm going to go with the same team too. I think they're going to work very well together, use that sort of mix of high-flying and, you know, technical ability.
That's seen down. Is Danny Six going for the cover early on, and Sami Zayn gets a two. Could have been over right there.
Yeah, I don't think Neville quite expected the pinfall ready to get a two count.
And now look at this, Sami Zayn coming back with now kicks and punches of his own. Danny Six is, as I say, both four men in this ring, guys, big fan favourite. The crowd 50-50 here already, and you can think they'll be pleased whoever wins.
Yeah, I think all four of these guys will just, you know, look to put on a great match for our audience, and well, they'll try and do well, they can to get the big win at the same time.
But look at this, Daniel Bryan coming around. And all of a sudden now, Daniel Bryan getting involved.
Yep. You know, showing off great tag team prowess, and you know, letting Day 6 get the advantage over Sami Zayn.
The referee has got a 10 count to play with here. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, whoever wins this match will become number one contenders for Mundo and AJ Styles. Tag team titles. The match will take place next week right here on SmackDown.
Yes, yeah, so that's a big opportunity for both of these tag teams.
Look at this, Sami Zayn with two lovely clotheslines, and then the drop kick right to the face of Daniel Bryan. Zayn rolling here, Marky.
He's just running right through.
Oh no, look at this. Oh, Daniel Bryan turning back, and then oh! Zayn missed! He hit Adrian Neville, and then the Bulldog by Sami Zayn.
Wow.
Neville taking one for the team there.
Yeah, but that could have worked out greatly for Zayn and Neville.
And look at this, now the quick tag. Neville got back up. Look out, here it comes. Oh.
And there's a chest hold into the elbow drop.
Classic NSW, and look out, Neville, my goodness.
It's a reverse Hurricane Rana, like. Spiked Danny Bryan's head into the ground.
Bryan could be out. Cover. Oh, what a win for Neville and Zayn here tonight.
And wow, they get a shot at the tag team titles.
The High Flyers.
Such a huge opportunity.
Yeah, the High Flyers and the Cruiserweight get the tag team opportunity next week here on SmackDown.
Karen, well, they look extremely happy. They're getting a huge opportunity to prove what they can do as a tag team.
Wow, big win here tonight for Neville and Sami Zayn, your new tag team number one contenders. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, if you have missed our last pay-per-view, it is Night of Champions. It is up now on the network for you to watch at any time you like. Simply only go to Nonstop Wrestling UK. It's all you need to do, ladies and gentlemen, and all you can watch any of our past pay-per-views or shows. It is all there for you in full with nothing taken out. Why not go back, watch Night of Champions, great pay-per-view from NSW this past Sunday. And then, of course, ladies and gentlemen, we go forward to our next pay-per-view. As I say, one of my favourite pay-per-views is Money in the Bank. Comes your way live on May the 24th, starting at 10 o'clock in the UK. 5 in the East, 2 in the West. Guys, Money in the Bank, if it's as good as last year, we're in for some pay-per-view.
Yeah, definitely agree with that. Money in the Bank, one of the most exciting matches in NSW. And can't wait to see who gets that contract.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, this is to determine the new number one contender for the European Championship. Daniel Cage, DM West, Ryback, and Morgan Wolf. It's coming up next.
Yep, and well, should be a great matchup, and who will get that number one contender shot?
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring first. He is from London, England. He is DM West.
And here comes DM West, who's well, definitely been proving himself. You know, he had a big opportunity, Elimination Chamber, came up short in that, but showed what he could do. Now he's got another big opportunity to get a shot at the European Championship.
Well, if DM West can pick up the win here, he has really a big opportunity coming his way.
Nathan Welch just scouting a ring.
Yeah.
Well, just at methodical pace. And
just the way it is, cares about nobody, Marky. DM West, well, if you could win this, what a win it would be for him.
Yeah, the one wolf, can you do it?
And his one of his opponents, he is the big guy, Ryback!
And here we see, it's a big guy Ryback, a former NSW champion, and well, I definitely think, imagine seeing Ryback take on Umuggle. It's like, trying to forget the term now.
Former Bisping boy going against
yeah.
Still a Bisping boy.
Yeah, that would be interesting. We've still got Morgan Wolf, remember? What if Morgan Wolf wins this?
Yeah, imagine that as well. It'd be, well, it'd be Bisping boy taking on Bisping boy.
Yeah, of course, ladies and gentlemen, you've only got two matches left. This in the main event, if you want to win the prize, you've got to get your votes in. You've got to tell us who you think's going to win. There's no point holding back now. It's now or never in these last two matches. Ryback ready for action. And his opponent coming to the ring, Daniel Cage.
Yep, and well, there we see Daniel Cage, and another guy with who's had a lot of achievements. No world championships, and well, another guy I think who could take it to Umuggle.
And he said before, he says when he beats the other three guys in the ring, he is gonna go after Umuggle and then knock the taste out of Bisping's mouth.
Yeah, well, Bisping could be in a lot of trouble.
Marky, well, you were gonna say something there.
Well, first he's gotta get past these three other wrestlers.
That is true, yeah, that is actually true.
Yep, but there we see that's very ready for this.
Daniel Cage ready for action. Yeah, in this fatal four-way coming up. And look at them just, well, DM West and Ryback just staring at Daniel Cage. Daniel Cage saying he is the people's champ. He'll have to prove it tonight. And the final man in this fatal four-way, he is Morgan Wolf.
Well, there we see Morgan Wolf. Well, Bisping boy as well. So imagine him taking on Umuggle. Could be very interesting to see. I see Morgan Wolf as maybe a little bit of an outsider in this match.
You've got to think though, Marky. Morgan Wolf wouldn't care who he takes on. He's that kind of person that only really thinks about himself.
And also, if Morgan Wolf wins, who is Bisping going to side with?
Well, we'll find out. Here we go then, ladies and gentlemen. It is Fatal 4-Way Elimination Rules. Remember, NSW rules is elimination when it's always more than two men in the ring. Or women, of course. Let's see what the guys think. Let's start with Tim.
You know, I'm going to go with Daniel Cage. I said he's got so many accomplishments to his name, and I think he wants to add the European Championship too. Now, I think he's a guy that could really take it to Umuggle.
Okay, what about you, Marky?
I'm going to have Morgan Wolf. I think it'll be interesting to see if the Bisping boys go at it.
Let's find out. And look at DM West planting right back with a big DDT. And now Daniel Cage stomping on Morgan Wolf.
I thought of the term if Ryback and Umuggle men are in. The unstoppable force, meaning the immovable object.
Oh my goodness me, that is so true. Could you imagine if them two, I think we would have to reinforce the ring for them to win this.
Yeah, well, I think we definitely would have to.
It could break.
Well, it would. So, it could do. You never know with them two. Look at DM West. Oh, DM West not backing down from right back here. Morgan Wolf ramming Daniel Cage's face into the canvas. Both men going off here. And look out! Spine buster by DM West.
Yeah, he says he's taking it to right back and...
Now into the ankle lock.
Showing no fear.
Oh, Morgan went for the big... springboard, didn't get anywhere. DM West throwing the punches at right back. We've got to keep eyes in the back of our head here, because anything could happen. As Morgan Wolf dumped to the outside.
Yeah, you could see in matches like this, you could see unlikely alliances forming.
Yeah, but look at this, DM West, nice drop kick.
I mean, think of this unlikely alliance: DM West and Morgan Wolf teaming up in this match.
They've had plenty of battles down in NXT. It could happen here on. In this match tonight. And of course, remember, ladies and gentlemen, just while we're in the middle of the match, remember, it's our sponsor here in NSW, it's Florida Water. It's fruity Florida Water. Get it in some good stores
and some bad ones.
Hey, they're in tandem. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, I have the plane. Marky, quickly, what do you have?
A berry blast, as always.
And Tim?
I have got the cherry, as always.
Okay, look out, Daniel Cage going for the submission. Oh no, too close to the rope. Oh, nice.
Oh, suplex stunner, you'd say.
Yeah, and then dropping the knee right down across Ryback.
Ryback's in a lot of trouble.
No, he's getting himself back up. Oh, Daniel Cage went for the splash. Morgan moved out the way. Can Morgan take advantage on Daniel Cage here?
No, he's definitely looking to take advantage of the situation that was handed to him. And is he going what for? I think he is.
Look at this. Oh, my goodness. DM West going for the cover on Ryback. Gets a two. And yeah. Well, Morgan showing Daniel Cage he's up for the fight here tonight. Is again, look at the strength by DM West.
I say I'm very impressed with the strength he's showing against a guy like Ryback.
Again, the Ryback only kicking out at one. Ryback into the corner. Oh, what a kick. Marky, what do you make of this match so far?
It's been a great match so far. I mean, everyone's been sticking to one person so far. I mean, I wonder why they're doing that.
Oh, Ryback was almost eliminated, kicking out at 2.9. And look at this again. Night, Ryback. Lovely. Lovely. Cage goes for Morgan Wolf. And Morgan Wolf is eliminated.
Yep, and the ref, start counting the pin.
Cover. Ryback is eliminated.
And wow, it comes down to Daniel Cage and DM West.
Oh, my goodness me. We're down at two. The winner of this match is going to take on Umuggle.
And oh no. Oh god.
Goodness.
DDT into the, well, the side of the canvas. There's not as much padding there.
Yeah, and look at Daniel Cage. They're just, really, this is maybe a bad thing giving DM West a chance to get back up.
Yeah, you know, you've got to capitalize on the situation and not, you know, let the opponent get a second win, because then that'll happen.
Yeah, DM West moving out the way. Where's he going now? Going to use some springboard maneuvers. Oh, he clips Daniel Cage. He looks ready. Big DDT.
And this is a big opportunity for DM West here.
Where's he going? Springboard again. Oh, knees right into the midsection.
And Daniel Cage looks like he's in a lot of trouble, but nope. And
Cage, abdominal stretch.
He's got it locked in, and is DM West going to tap? Will it be Daniel Cage taking on Umuggle?
Marky, if this was good for AJ Lee earlier on, could this be the end of DM West here tonight?
Can this end DM West continue? Cage be the one to go and smack the mouth out of Bisping's mouth?
Yeah, that's what he said. He said he was going to promise it. Can he get DM West to tap right here?
DM West looks like he's in a lot of trouble here.
He's not getting out of this, is he?
No, he looks like he's fading.
Yeah, he looks like he is fading really bad. Daniel Cage desperate to get this. No, look at this. DM powers out.
And wow, he powers out of that. Not letting Daniel Cage in. Oh, it's a big clothesline.
Look out. Face first. DM West is rolling all of a sudden. Into the cover. No hook of the leg. Is that enough? He got him!
My goodness.
And wow. It's going to be DM West taking on Umuggle for the European Championship.
DM West becomes your new number one contender for the European title.
And well, Demis has got a big opportunity ahead of him, but it is against Umuggle, so... Well, we have seen Demis beat Umuggle in the past before, though.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match, our new number one contender, Demis!
Well, it's a huge win for him and a huge opportunity.
Well, welcome back down the ringside, ladies and gentlemen. Marky Marks and Tim Price, alongside myself, Dave Easton. Guys, we're ready for a big main event. CM Barnett and Adrian Kincade taking on Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins. And Tim, if Lesnar's... You know Lesnar's going to be absolutely fuming after them two took him out on Sunday night.
Yeah, and that's one thing... That's one man you do not want to get angry. Should I say beast you do not want to get angry is... Brock Lesnar, because it could end your career.
Well, here they come, ladies and gentlemen. Adrian Kincade, CM Barnett. These two guys, well, they completely destroyed Brock Lesnar after Lesnar beat Barnett for the title this past Sunday. And we are ready to go for your main event of SmackDown this week. Who is going to win? Barnett, Kincade against Lesnar and the sellout, Seth Rollins.
You mean the boy in Seth Rollins, but, well, this is going to be... Great tag team match, and Brock Lesnar is looking for revenge.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring first, he is CM Barnett.
Yep, CM Barnett, the well former NSW champion, who, well, we saw, in my opinion, we saw him get dominated by Lesnar. Lesnar is just a man possessed at the moment, and I think Barnett's put himself in at a bit of a corner here tonight.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, just a reminder, this is your last chance, the last match of the month to get your points in. The points will be reset, so no matter if you're not, if you're going to go in for just a low amount, it might not matter, because come after the night, it will be reset. It's that important for you guys. So let us know who you think's going to win. CM Barnett making his way into the ring of the former NSW champion.
Well, there we can see CM Barnett looks ready for this, but has he dug himself into a hole that he won't be able to escape when Lesnar gets out here?
Well, we are going to find out here tonight. And his tag team partner, he is Adrian Kincade.
And when I look at Adrian Kincade, all I can think is, has this man lost his mind?
Well, you know what? Disrespected by Heyman, turned on him, and well, this all happened back at Elimination Chamber, remember that?
Yeah, that's when what he it thought was. It'd be a good idea to not help Lesnar.
Kincade's in the match, why can't he go for the title?
Yeah, it's a free-for-all.
Well, he should have helped Lesnar until CM Barnett was eliminated. Then those two could have gone at it. But no, he was an idiot.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here comes the pain.
Yep, here comes the pain, and well, he is ready to bring the pain to CM Barnett.
Ladies and gentlemen, main his way to the ring. He is your new NSW champion, Brock Lesnar.
Yep. CM Barnett and Adrian Kincade better be ready, because I think they're going to feel a lot of pain tonight,
Marky,
after Brock Lesnar's finished.
Yeah, Marky, Lesnar, you don't want to be in the ring when Lesnar's in a bad mood, and you know Lesnar's in a bad mood.
Yeah, we all seen what he did to Ryback a few weeks ago when he just obliterated him.
Yeah, but I think he's ready to continue.
I think he is. And his tag team partner, he is your first ever NSW Cruiserweight Champion, Seth Rollins.
There we see Seth Rollins, who bought in to Paul Heyman and became a Paul Heyman guy, and now he's the Cruiserweight Champion, the first Cruiserweight Champion. So you know what, it looks like buying in is a great career move and is best for business.
Can I just say, this guy has got a massive target on his back, Marky, when Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose come back.
Yeah, when they come back, no one's going to be able to stop them.
Well, I think the rest of Paul Heyman guys can do that.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We are off and underway for the match main event. Let's see what the guys think, starting with Tim.
You know, I've got to go with Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins. They're both champions. I think they're both want, you know, Brock Lesnar wants revenge the most, but I think even Seth Rollins is itching for a bit of revenge.
Marky?
I'm going to go for CM Barnett and Kincade. I'm not going to count them out. They both had great wins, and Barnett, of course, was the previous champion. I think he can do it.
Well, and 74.3% going for Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins. 25.7% only going for Barnett and Kincade. NSW are going for the champions here. And Barnett already seems to be in a lot of trouble. As anyone, even a sellout, can do a Russian leg sweep.
Yeah, you faced that wrong. You meant to see even a buy-in.
Well, look at this. What the hell? Why is Hunter up?
He's just observing the match, making sure everything's going right. The ref isn't, you know, could try and screw over Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins.
Well, look at this now. Kick into the midsection. Barnett rolling here. Nice drop kick right to the side of the face. Another one just under the chin. Looking for that swinging neck breaker. Hits it perfectly. Now where's he going?
And hey, leave the table alone, please.
Oh, Lesnar cuts him off.
Thank you, Lesnar. But
Kincade has yet to get in this match.
I'll say thank you.
Oh, my.
Can't be doing that.
Hey, you can't take your eyes off of Brock Lesnar, otherwise he'll grab you and cut you off.
Yeah. Well, ladies and
gentlemen, Seth Rollins calling for the end already.
Maybe he is. Look out! Seth Walker!
And he hits it's the pin.
Is that enough? He got it!
Got it!
And Seth Rollins picks up a huge win, and Lesnar, Kincade didn't even get into the match.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins.
I think Sam Barnett was still feeling the effects of the beating he was served at Night of Champions. That was just domination.
Wow. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Lesnar and Rollins, your champions and your winners tonight. Hold on. What's this? Kincade looking over here. Look out, Adrian Kincade. Oh, ref.
And there we go. There's the measure of revenge that those two wanted.
Oh, this is grand. This is not on. Come on. Guys, come on.
So when Kincade and Sam Barnett
Barnett rolled out of the ring.
Okay, but when these two get a measure of revenge, oh, you're all against it. Bunch of hypocrites.
The sellout.
Ladies and gentlemen, what is Kincade going to be in after that beating at the end? Well, what a night of SmackDown we've had. And guys, thanks very much for your company. Marky, say goodbye to the fans.
Bye, fans.
Tim, say goodbye to the fans.
Goodbye, fans.
That's it, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks very much for watching. We'll see you for NSW NXT, which is going to be a huge episode this Saturday night. Till then, Dave Easton, Tim Price, Marky Marks. We'll see you for NXT.